In this video, we take a look at how to create a church service flyer for 31st night like this in Photoshop. And this is coming up. Hey everybody, it's Innocent here and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So a link to download the resources that I'll be using in this video will be in the description. Feel free to download it, practice, and send it to me on IG. Let's get interacted. Now let's get into Photoshop and let's get started. So first off, let's go ahead and create a new document. I'm using Photoshop CS6, so I'll go to File and New, and I'm going to create a new document of 8x8 inches. You can go for 4x4 or 16x16, but this should be fine for us, especially if you are using this for social media. So let's go ahead and click OK. So the first thing we do is we're going to create a new rectangle over here. So you go for the rectangle tool and then you're going to create a rectangle. It can go overboard, it doesn't really matter. So we're going to create it somewhere around here and we're going to give it a color. So I'll double click on the layer thumbnail and then I'll go inside of my color palette over here. I've already got my color set up. Okay, so this is the hex code that I'm using if you want to copy that. And then I'm going ahead and I'm going to click OK. Now the next thing that we do is we're going to right click on this rectangle. So you right click on this one, go to rasterize layer because we want to apply an effect on this. And then what we do next is we go for the lasso tool over here, L for lasso tool. And then we want to create a sort of effect on this one. So this is the rough edges effect that most people have been using. So what we're going to do is we're going to left click and then we're going to create just a rough edge, something like this one. So basically you just left click and then you'll be moving your mouse like that. I'm not really going to get a perfect one, but once you get to this point, you can come back to the initial place that you started like this, and then you can go ahead and then you can delete this one. Once you're done, you press Ctrl D and then you can deselect this one. Now what you can do is you can bring this one a little bit, but since we've rasterized it, all I need to do is press Ctrl T and then you can increase it up so that we can push it down a little bit like that. The next thing we do is we go to filter and then to Gaussian blur, and then we can blur this out a little bit like this so that it will not be that very solid, and we can click OK. After we're done with this, let's go into our resource and we have some backgrounds over there, we can actually use them. So the first one that I bring in is this one. I'll drag and drop it inside of Photoshop and then I can open this one up. Now I always preach about getting highly resolution images for your works, and then you double click on this one, right click and rasterize. You press Ctrl Shift and then U, and then you can desaturate this. You right click and then you can create a clipping mask so it fits right inside of the rectangle that you created. The next thing you do is go to the blend mode over here and then you can change this one to overlay. Now it fits right inside of this one. Go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur, and then you apply a couple of blur onto the background as well, so something like that, and then you can go ahead and click OK. Now I got two backgrounds for you, so you can feel free to use the other one, and this feels like it's too small for me, so let me select all of them, press Ctrl T, and then I can transform it a little bit so that I can get space to push it down somewhere around here. I think this looks good for me. Alright, so from here we can go in and bring in our subjects, and in this video I'm going to use the presiding bishop of the Methodist Church Ghana. A disclaimer here that this isn't an actual program that is coming on, I'm just using a picture for educational purpose. So I'm going to drag and drop the Most Reverend Paul Kobina Boafo, and I'm going to drop him here, and you can realize from here that I got my actual color from the subjects. So that is one simple way to get colors if you are working on your designs. So I can push him to the very left side a little bit so that we make space for this side, because at the end of the day we're going to put up some text over here as well. So we press Ctrl T and we can transform him up a little bit like that, bring him over here. We don't want the edges underneath over there to show, and then I can right click, rasterize the layer, and then I can add a bit of adjustment to it. So I'll press Ctrl L and then I can adjust the image a little bit so that it blends or the compositioning becomes very fine. From here, we can just go ahead straight and add our main title and all the other text to this one. So I made this 3D text and I'm going to drag it inside of Photoshop. All of them will be in the description if you want to use it. But if you want to create your own as well, you can just type a very simple text, go to the 3D option in Photoshop, and then it will create something similar to this one for you. So I'm going to drag it to the very right side over here. So I'll place it somewhere around this side. Quite simple like that. And then I can go ahead and add the rest of my text to this. So the first text that I'm going to add, I've already tested it up over here. I'm going to pick my text tool and I'm going to copy my text over here. So the first one will be the Methodist Church. I'll copy that and I'll paste it over here. So I'll select all of it, go to the color palette here, and then I can change my text color to white and I'll click OK. So we can press Ctrl T and transform this one out like this. And we can send it over here, place it at the extreme left side. You just have to make sure that it is in alignment with the 31st night over there. So the next thing that I do is I'll pick my text tool again, and then I can select my present here. I'll go to the color palette, click on it, and then I can pick this particular color that we are using. So the moment you place your cursor over here, you can pick the exact same color. And then you can go ahead and click OK. Alright, so from here we can go ahead and press Ctrl J to duplicate this one. And we can send it underneath of the 31st night over here. Select all of it, that is, you go for the text tool. And then you can select all of this one and then you can type in here crossover service or something like that. So crossover service. And then you can press Ctrl T, transform this one to be bigger. And then you can position it over here. Is that very simple, isn't it? All right, so the next of the things that we're going to do is to add the date, venue, and then the time to it. And then, of course, the few effects that we have to apply to this one. So first off, we're going to add the date and then the venue to this one. But let's go for the theme first. So I'm going to go according to how I've arranged this one over here. So the first one is the theme, and I'm going to just make a duplicate of the crossover here, bring it underneath of this one, double click on the layer thumbnail here, and then we can select the color and we can change our color to this particular color over here. So I'm picking this one for the text arrangement. So what I do is I'm changing all of these one to left align, and then I can position it over here. So we will select all of this one and I'm going to change it to the same poppins but medium this time. And I'll go into my text and I'm going to copy the theme over here. So I'll copy that and I'll paste it over here. Now I'll take my time, press Ctrl T to transform it to the very part that I want it to be. And the next thing that I'll do is I'll make sure that I go for a ruler here so that I can know the exact place that I want it to end. So let me place this one here and let me zoom in right over there. So I'll place this one there. So the next thing I do is I'll go for my rectangle tool. So the rectangle tool here, and I can go ahead and make a very small rectangle like this one. Now I'll zoom in very well and I'll double click on the layer thumbnail and I make sure that I pick the same color for this one. And then I'll go for my move tool and I'll drag this one to be in alignment with the E, so right over there. So you can just go ahead and zoom in very well so that you can get the exact pixels, and then you can stretch it to fit the E over there, so something like that, and you are good to go. With this done, I'll go back to my theme here and I'll make another duplicate. I'll drag it on top of the rectangle and then I can drag it beneath here. So I'm just going to select all of that again, go to my text, and then I'm going to copy this particular theme here. Like I said earlier, this is just for educational purpose. It is not an actual program that is coming on. So I'll select all of that and I'll make sure that I'll drag this to the very side. So I'll place my cursor over here, drag it to the very side, so something like that. And I make sure that it is in alignment with the line over here. So I'll press Ctrl T to transform that. and then I can position it over here. So that'll be it for the seam over there. Very simple. I'll then go ahead, make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J again, drag it to the very bottom over here, and then I can select it, go to my test, and I have my day over there. So Friday, 31st December, let me select it over there, and then I can paste it right over here. Now I can select all of it, go to the toggle character, and then I can decrease it right over there. That is, I decrease the leading over here, and then it can be that very simple for me. So after that, we're going to select only the Friday here. We select it like this, and we're going to increase the size so that it will be on the same level with that of the December. So something like that, and it becomes very bold. And we can push it down a little bit like that. We have some space to use. And let's make another duplicate of the same Friday, 31st December. Drag it to the right side over here like that. And we go into our test. We have the 8 o'clock p.m. Just going to copy that. And then we paste it over here as well. So after that, I'll just drag this inside of the middle here. Push it to the right side a little bit. And then I can go for my rectangle tool again. So I have my rectangle here, and I'll create another rectangle over here to separate that of the date and then the time. So I'll just double click on this one, make sure that the color palette is active, and I can come and select this and click OK. Now the space here is too much. I didn't even realize that it was going overboard. So I'll drag it to the very left side, and this is what we have so far. The next thing that we do is we're going to add the venue, which is also going to be very simple. So we want to create this on top of the 8 o'clock p.m. here. So we're just going to bring it underneath here. And to do that, I'm just going to pick my rectangle tool again, and I'm going to create a rectangle. Let me zoom out so that you can see. So I'm going to create a rectangle over here, something like this. And I want to make sure that it is down here a little bit like that. Okay. And let me try to open it up, something small like that. And I'll right click on this one. We want to add an effect today. So I'll right click, go to the blending options over here. And under the blending options, we have gradient overlay. So I'll pick gradient overlay, and I've already set my gradient. So I'll go into the gradient, and I'll pick this particular gradient. So these are the hex codes. If you want to use the same thing, it is actually the same color that we are using, but we are using the upper tones and then the lower tones. And then I'll go ahead and click OK. Come to the angle here, and I'm going to change this one to 0 so that it will be like a linear one for me. So I'll go ahead and then I'll click OK from here as well. Now inside of our resource, we have this location icon over here. So we want to bring it inside of Photoshop, but then let's try to create something very simple over here. So on top of the rectangle, I'm going to add a new layer. So we come to the very bottom of Photoshop here, and then you have the create a new layer. So you create a new layer, and then you go to your shapes, you right click, and then you can choose the ellipse over here. Hold shift and create a very simple ellipse like that. And let's go to the layer thumbnail here, double click on it, and we're going to change the color to white. Now let's try and bring this one over here so that it creates that sort of cut for us. So somewhere around here. And then we can go ahead and bring the location icon into that particular ellipse that we created. So left click and drag it inside of Photoshop, and then you can bring it over here. Now zoom out, or let me zoom out, and I'm going to transform this one. I'll zoom in back, so something like that. And then I can just take this one over here, quite simple like that. Okay, so that will be the location for us. We can right click on this one, rasterize it, right click again, go to the blending options, and then we can go to color overlay, select the color overlay here, pick this color, and then we are good to go. So you click okay, and then you are done with this one. So the next thing that we do is we add another test. So let's quickly go for the test tool again. Create a test on top of this one, go to our test, and then I have this one over here. I'll copy that and I'll paste it right over here. All this while I'm using the same font for this. It makes your design very minimal and very simple. you don't have to use like a lot of fonts in designs, right? So you go to the color palette over here, click on it, and then you can change your color to white, which makes a lot of sense, and then it blends with this particular text a lot. Now the last text that we add will be the more info, so I'll make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, drag it to the very bottom, go to my text over here, I'll select my text, copy that, and then I'll come and select all of this one, and then I can paste it over here. Now I'll select it all again, go to my color or my color palette, and then I can change the color to the dark one over here. Now this time around, let me go and use the semi bold, and then I can press Ctrl T, transform this one, and then I can place it over here. Now remember, I said this is not an actual program, it is something to just show you how I came up with this concept. So the last things that we add to this design will be the logo and then the effect. So for the logo, we want to place it beside the Methodist Church Ghana, that is the church name. So I'll zoom into that one and I'll select it. I'll go into my resource and I have my logo over there. So this is my logo. I'll drag and drop it inside of Photoshop. I'll place it at the extreme left over here. Transform it to be a bit smaller like that, and then I can double click on it, and that is it for the logo. The last thing that we add will be our effect, and for that I'm going to use the lens flare, this lens flare right over here. So I want to place that particular lens flare on top of the 31st night over here, so I'll come and select that, and that is where we're going to place the lens flare. So let's go into the resource over here, and then we can bring this particular lens flare inside of Photoshop. So we're going to transform it to be a bit bigger. You realize that the more bigger it is, the more it shines and brightens. So you open it up like that, you can double click on it after you're done. Now right click on this one, rasterize the layer, go to the blending mode and set this to screen. So everything is gone excluding the shiny part of it. Now you go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur, and then you can add some Gaussian blur to it so that it can be very smooth like that. And after you're done, you click OK, and then you can drag it to this very side. Now let me press Ctrl T and try to open it up some more like this so that it shines some more. And what I can do is I can press on Ctrl U to activate the hue and saturation, and I can drag this to this very side so that I can get this particular thing over there. Now realize that you can also drag it to the right side over here, and it will give you like a total different set of colors. But then you realize that this particular one over here is kind of seems to blend with our image sort of. And once you get the exact color you want, you can go ahead and then you can click OK. Also, if you want to use the actual color that came with this one, you are free to use that. Now, the last thing we do is we're going to add a layer mask to this. You realize that it has affected the image and everything here because we placed it on top of the 3D text. So we'll add a layer mask, we'll go for the brush tool, and we're going to brush off the parts that we don't want so it is overexposed. Right over here, we're going to brush all of these parts, excluding the lighting part over here. Of course, you might want to add the name of the pasta as well, because it is also very, very important and very necessary as well. And yes, that's it for this video. That is how to create a church flyer for 31st night. And I hope you gained value from this video. If you did, why don't you subscribe and then share this video to others so that they can come and then watch videos for free. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to subscribe and like and share, and I wish you all a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and I hope this new coming year will bring us the very best of things. Thank you for sticking around to watch. I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.